Topic I'm going to give today is a continuation of the topics I've been giving from last week. I started it actually from Friday, and it's the same trend of line of thoughts I'm bringing out here. So today the topic is the question or the topic I'm going to look. It says, you want to be a stay-at-home mom or dad? Then check out my ultimate, or check out this ultimate reasons why a lot of parents are turning out their attention to home-based business, either full-time or part-time. So this is the line of thought for today, yeah? Well, naturally or generally, most of us, especially those of us who are parents, most of you will agree with most of this point that I'm going to bring. Because you know, when you think of the competing demands on time and money, the family environment may suffer, which is true and which is the fact. Because time, money, if we don't have time for family, and when you think of the finance within the family, if it's tight, it can also really tell on the family relationship. Because like spouse can't have enough time with each other, and also parents and children don't spend enough time with them together. And also when you think, because there are lots of demand, especially if both couples they are working, they have maybe full-time job. So at their job, when you think of the demand of maybe their office work and the deadlines they need to meet maybe to end in their job. Also, you think of great competitions between workers, that maybe some who want to outshine the others, or maybe some who want to really be noticed. So everybody's trying to really do extremely. And then this kind of competition goes in the workplace. And you think of maybe backbiting and things like that starts to going on. And it can even be so stressful that when spouse come home, because they cannot release that stress at work, then definitely it affects the family. So whatever, maybe the other spouse, or maybe the children, maybe they say or do something little, it trigger this emotion, and you know, temper begin to rise. So because of all this, and some will be thinking, I want to quit my job because I don't have time with my family, or I don't like the situation going. Yeah, this situation that going on in the home. But most of the time, most of the family member, it's difficult for them to really realize that the stress has already come from the workplace, which some do really think of that, but it's not everybody who really have that line of thought that they already have this stressful moment from work. Yeah, and because you cannot really release your stress from work, then definitely your job will really be in danger. So normally most keep it inside, then they release it in a different way, and most of the time it affects the family. Yeah, and situation like this, everyone's patience wear out very, very thin as they deal with this kind of emotion and this kind of situation. And also based on the financial troubles, most probably that they may have within the family. And most of the time, this causes clash within the family, this kind of situation. So to solve these issues, this kind of conflict, to solve these issues, simply quitting your job isn't the right option, because some might have this line of thought they will want to quit their job to have this kind of peace. But really, it's not the ultimate option as at the beginning, because one income doesn't go far enough in providing everything we want for our families. And most of you who are parents, definitely I know you will agree with me. Yeah, if anybody agree with me, I would really love to have a one. Or good evening, Alusanya, welcome this evening. Yeah, if you agree with me, I would love for you to just drop me a one down at the comment section. Yeah, and of course, everybody have their own right to have a different opinion. Yeah, but if you agree, if you think of it as a parent, definitely most of you will agree with me. So how can these issues be solved or fixed? How can we fix this situation, all the stressful situation we experience in family? Well, one thing I would say, normally working from home is a great way to earn extra income and devote more time to your family. It is one great way. As you can see on the topic, this is what most couples they are doing now, turning their attention to having their own home business, to be their own boss, to set their own working time, to set their own working plans, to set their own working hours. They don't need the alarm clock to all the time be going on and waking them up. So this is what most parents, whether it's the mom or the dad, they are turning their attention to. And most often, moms and fathers, they cannot even afford to stay home from work to raise their children without putting a financial strain on the family. Because if you simply say you're going to quit your job to avoid this conflict, this stress, then definitely you're going to put a strain on the financial on the finance in the family, and this can even cause more stress within the family. Yeah, but also even though parents also strongly believe, or they strongly feel, that even placing their children in daycare or home care for the whole day is also not ideal for the family or for the children as well. So working from home is a fantastic way to allow yourself the opportunity to better manage your time spent with your family or with your children, and still whilst you are earning extra income outside. So the stay-at-home mom or dad, they will also feel less guilty about not having quality time with their children. So because they have all this quality time with their children, it's gonna boost the family and give more healthy relationship in the family. So working from home allows also parents and children to be rewarded with extra time for each other, which is a very, very fantastic relationship, a very fantastic feeling for the family. Yeah, so you will be able to witness like all of your children first. Like if you have a young kid or a baby, maybe you just come back from your maternity, you will experience all their first, like when they have their first steps, when they have their first feet, when they have their first words. Most of them, their first words is daddy. And most of the fathers, they are always excited about these words. Because even though we parents or we mothers, we are the one who spend more time with the children, but you see the kids, their first word most of the time is daddy. Yeah, so it's really, even though it's daddy, most of them is their first word, but it really brings this happiness because you are there to experience that. Yeah, even their first food, you are there to give them their first normal food. So, and while allowing you to continue to your financial support for your family, that is when you have your own home business. Yeah, but there are also a lot of challenges that normally home business owners also face, because when you think of the good side, we also have to think of the offsets as well that is happening, because it's not everything cannot just like go completely 100%, because nothing is perfect. So you must have this kind of imbalance a little bit. But again, good evening, Uncle Lulu. How are you? You're welcome this evening. Good evening, Videla. You're welcome this evening. Yeah. So again, the challenge is mom and dad who choose to like have a home-based business may also find it difficult to balance their responsibility to their children and also still accomplish all the work that needs to be completed by by their deadline, you know, for their own business. Because it's very important to have a deadline, to have a plan for your business. So sometimes it's also have this challenge, how to balance these two, taking care of the family at the same time taking care of your business. Yeah. So a stay-at-home parent deal with also the added stress of being there to take care of the children, just like I said, while they are taking care of their business. So how can parents or stay-at-home mom or dad eliminate these challenges? How can they eliminate these challenges? Well, for me, actually, I'm also into home business, and I'm also a wife, and I'm also a mother, and I've experienced this in the beginning. So, and I'm not the only one. I know also many, many others who are parents, who are also having their own home business, and in the beginning, how they solve these challenges that they face. Most of them face this same challenge. Yeah, because it's a new way of living. Yeah, so well, one thing you must be able to allocate time to each role and to have structure in your daily environment to accomplish what needs to be done. You need to have a structure. You need to allocate time for everything. It is very, very important. Yeah, so you want to write down out a schedule or schedule to identify what needs to be done each and every single day, and how long you have to accomplish each task. It is very important to write them down. As for me, I have everything down, so I know every day what exactly I need to be done. You see, like I don't know if it will turn right. Like this one of my plan, I also have it electronics on my computer, and I also have it in paper form. I also have it in my phone, so I have it different where that I can easily reach to it. Yeah, this is like my weekly plan, and also my daily plan is also there. It's part of it. So I make sure I list these things down. This part, this ones I show you is what I need to accomplish for my business, my plans, daily action, weekly, and at the same time, I break it down a daily plan, what needs to be done. Yeah, so all of them have tasks, time in them. How long or which time do I want to do this particular thing? Then I always have like alarm clock that help me to keep in track of my time as well. And also, it is very important to have a weekly goal, because you just like I showed you on this paper, you have a weekly goal, and also plan out your week with what needs to be accomplished each day, and also by the end of the week. Then each morning, or most normally, I do it in the evening before I go to bed. I need to prioritize things that you need to work on for your business, yeah, and also items that need to be done with in regards to taking care of your family, taking care of the household responsibilities, yeah. And also, as you complete each portion successfully, you will begin to become more confident that you will accomplish more. So it is very, very important. You don't want to really like set big goals that will make you become overwhelmed in doing them, but you want to set small goals so that it's very easy for you to accomplish quickly and move on to the next task. So the smaller you set goals, the quicker you will go, because the larger goals you set makes you move very slow. For me personally, because everybody is different, I believe in setting small goals, and it makes me even move very, very quicker in my daily tasks. And also, it is important that you discuss your schedule needs with your spouse. It is very, very, very important, because if you can reach agreement on sharing free time, like the household chores and the things like that, then you will increase your chance of being successful with your schedule. Because you want to decide, okay, who will do what, who will do this thing at this certain time, and let your spouse also know what time you have set aside to work on your business, yeah? Because working out your schedule with your spouse and children will help to ensure that your goal or your working at home is a family goal. Because when you are a family person, whatever you're doing is not for individual self, but it is for the family. So you want to make it clear, you want to have this clear that it is a family goal. Yeah, so that's why it's very important that as a family you sit down and make this schedule for the home chores. But for your business, you have to fix your schedule out of the agreement you have with your spouse and your children. Yeah, and Also, you want to make your family be a part of your success and your opportunities and also your disappointments. Yeah, if even you have experienced this disappointment, you want them to be part of it, and you will be amazed. The thing is, you will be amazed at the support you will get from them, because when you have a disappointment somewhere, maybe in your business or whatever, then definitely you need someone to give you that support. Yeah, so it's very important to include them in your schedule. And also being able to stay at home with your children can also help them to advance very, very faster. Because according to research, research have shown that children whose parents work from home tend to thrive in their education, and they also do well in school. Why? Because they are more like kind of relaxed in their mind, and the parents also have more time to help them with their homework and other hobbies that they may have. Maybe if it's football, if they are boys, or maybe if it's dancing or whatever hobbies they have, the parents always participate in this, and which brings kind good feeling in the kids, yeah. And also they bond very, very fast. Children bond very fast to their parents as a role models than those that are not able to like stay at home with their parents. We can see that when the bond between children who have their parent there all the time and those who have their parents who work 5 to 7 job, the bond is different. Because when you think of it, when parents come from work 7 to 5 job, how much time do they have left? Let's say they're free from work 5 o'clock or even 4 o'clock. Then by the time they get home, at least maybe it would take them an hour or so. You think of preparing dinner, you think of maybe cleaning the home, you think of giving them shower, feeding the kids, putting them to bed, and then the day is gone. And then you start again all over the next day. So the time for you to bond with your kids is really, really not there. Yeah, which brings strain in the mother-child relationship as well. Yeah, and also children are able to receive, when parents stay at home, children are able to receive individualized attention from their parents, helping them to grow even and flourish. Yeah, because it's very important, and the environment tends to be more personalized and even nurturing towards the children when they have parents, either the mother or the fathers have a own business, doing business from home. So starting your own home business may be challenging to maintain in the beginning whilst you are taking care of your child or the family day-to-day tasks that needs to be done. Yeah, but it can be done when you properly planned your time, when you properly schedule your plan both for your business and for your work. It can be done. Like on my live yesterday, the topic yesterday, I said you can set, for me normally I set time in the evening. Stay at home mom, you can choose when you want to work. Most do it when their kids are sleeping, then they have time to do their job. Most do it like when, if the father is home, then he can be looking after them maybe an hour or two, whilst the mother or either the father, it depends who have the who is working at home, then they have this time to work on their business. Yeah, so this can even ease lots of stress. But again, schedule is very, very important to plan out your day-to-day activities in your business. It's very important. Also, you will learn to manage your time, to manage your company, and be your own boss. That is one of the fantastic benefits you also get from working at home. Yeah, and also while being there for all your kids' plays and their practices and their even musical events that they will be participating in throughout the year, if they are in musical or whatever activities they are based in. Yeah, so this is very, very important. It is very important that if you are a working mom, maybe you have full time, and maybe you are thinking of starting your own business, or maybe you have already started your own business at home part time, you can start your own business while you keep your day job. It is very important. You don't just like quit your day job, but you want to have your day job whilst you you are working on your business part-time. Yeah, that's why it's very important to have a plan, a weekly plan and a daily plan you want to be following each and every single day. Yeah, and also have a time in every single task that you're doing. You just need to have a daily schedule and make your daily action plan. That's the thing you need if you want to succeed, yeah. And also you want to be consistent and productive. It is very, very important that you don't do something today and you skip it, you wait next week and you skip it, then you lose the momentum, then you lose the you lose that rhythm that you already have, that routine. Then it is difficult for you to continue follow up on your business. But when you have a daily plan, you are very consistent and you are productive in everything you do on your business or in any area of your life, you will eventually reach your goal. Of course, it will go very slowly in the beginning because it's a learning phase. You need to learn so many things, so many new things maybe you are not conversant with, but at the same time, you are developing, you are growing. That is very, very important to remember. Sometimes maybe you don't see the finance coming like immediately, but at the same time, you are growing in your knowledge, your personality, your personal development, your mindset. Everything is growing. Your skill set as well, they are growing. Yeah. And another thing you can do to generate side income is you can also use an online affiliate marketing to allow you to work at home while building a revenue. Yeah. Affiliate marketing, like you, it is like you become a part, a member, or you sign up with a certain company and promote their product, and you get some commission on that. Yeah. And this also will help you to develop some finance at the side whilst building your business and whilst you are having your day job. Yeah. So you will also know when the time is right for you to quit your day job and spend more time doing the things you love doing, like spending time with your children, your spouse, hobbies and things you love doing your business. You will know when the time is switched, but don't quit your job until at least you get a 6 month residual income every month. Then you will know, okay, this is the time for me to quit my job. Yeah. And also, even though you may experience one or more of these challenges that I've just mentioned, you want to rest assured that with proper planning and goal setting and being action taker, you will learn to avoid or eliminate all of this stress, all of these challenges. You will definitely learn to avoid them. You don't it does not come overnight, but the more you plan, the more you schedule, the more you take action, slowly by slowly, you will see that you're getting there. Okay? So this is what I have for you, friends, today. I hope you guys you got value from this topic. If you do, I would love for you to like, to comment, to share with others as well. Yeah, and if you have any questions, maybe concerning this topic or something else in doing your own home business, you want to start, you don't know how to start, or maybe you have already started, but you need to come to the next level, whatever, or you need to learn something maybe you have been struggling with, I would really appreciate, or I would love for you to contact me, to send me message, to drop me message, on if you go on my Facebook fan page or my personal profile, my informations are there, the different ways you can reach me. Yeah, so I will definitely respond back to you and I will help you out as best as I can. Yeah, so just feel free to contact me in any way that you feel more comfortable with. Yeah. So I want to thank you all so much, Angela. Thank you so much, Angela Videla, Uncle Lulu, Alusain, Zulaibi. I want to thank you all of you that joined me this evening. I thank you all so much. And I'll see you guys not tomorrow. I normally don't come on weekends, Friday, Mondays to Fridays. So I will see you guys on Monday again, in continuation of this same line of thoughts. Yeah, So you all have an amazing, amazing evening and enjoy your weekend. And I'll see you guys on Monday. And it's bye for now.